My name is Natalie Restel, and I'm from Doki's First Nation.
Oh, so you've come all the way from Doki's?
All the way from Doki's.
Now, how long did it take you?
An hour and a half.
What do you think of the conference?
I think it's awesome, you know, just to have these resources provided to, like, Aboriginal youth, and it's just amazing because it's so hard for myself, even coming from myself, it's hard to find resources like this, and when you want to put something on like this, it's a lot of hard work, and having, like I said, having these resources provided to you and having elders here, it's amazing. Mm-hmm.
For me, we were just talking about, for me, I was expressing to the guys yesterday how I'm really confused, you know what I mean, right now with where I'm at and just with path to choose and stuff like that, because I've been introduced to two different paths, you know, this Western society path and then the Anishinaabe way path, you know what I mean, it's confusing, you know what I mean, it's which one do I choose, there's so much truth in both sides that I don't know, right, and we were just talking about that, the guys are helping me out with it and stuff like that.
Oh, it's been treating me good, and really enjoying it out here. Really love learning about the clan teachings, what the elder here was talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, pretty interesting. And
not stuff you learn in school?
No, it's not stuff that I learned in school.
A lot of things from everyone. You know, not just from the people who they were asked to come here. I learned from... I see little boys running around, I'll learn something from them. You learn something from everyone, so it's not just the bigger people part of the conference.
I've never been to anything like this, actually, like a cultural gathering or like youth and stuff like that. You know, I've never been to anything like that, so it's really nice. Started today off with a good sunrise ceremony, so it was good, you know what I mean? I think that's what actually gave me a lot of energy to stay up today, because like, I only got like I think an hour and a half of sleep, right? But like ceremonies and just the good vibes here and everything, right? It keeps you going.
Ani Bojo, Wawashkesh with the Gawin and Dejnikas, Wanapate and Donjiba. I wanted to talk about the importance of language and how it pretty much creates our identity as Anishinaabe people. The situation today is that I have children who are in school in elementary and they don't have any language resources in their school. So they're missing a big part of their identity, getting exposed to that at an early age. My vision for the future is to have early education include Anishinaabe language courses or classes. And something that I'm currently doing to help the situation is I have gotten in contact with the school boards and have requested that they bring in a teacher. And also I found, started a crafts class workshops in the afternoons or in the evenings in my community, and we do small Anishinaabewin teachings there. So,
my name's Forrest Wolf from Kedonstone Point First Nation. I'm here in Nipissing First Nation at the conference, and it's really interesting. I get filled in on everything I need to know on like residential schools. And like my tradition and my culture and what we went through. And yeah, it's awesome.
This conference so far has been so empowering and uplifting for the youth that I brought from my community and for myself. Just being able to take in everything, all the teachings, having our leadership here, being able to talk to them, having one-on-one conversations, learning from the elder, Gordon, and being able to share a lot of my own ideas and experiences and hopes for the future. And it's just been so rewarding. And to meet youth from our surrounding communities close to us too and interacting with them, it's just this conference is so important, and it makes us feel important. And
you know, it just takes one little thing to trigger a big spark and to let that fire go. Attending to other conferences, I hear elders always talk about this fire within us, and I think that's all that it had to take. You just hear someone start one thing, and just like the ripple effect, it goes. And once your fry catches, you just can't be stopped at that point. So we all have something to offer, and we all have a gift, and that's why we're here.